Do you know that you can see Instagram Insights, schedule posts, and also post IGTV on your desktop computer directly to Instagram? Not through the desktop version of the Instagram app, but through something called the Instagram Creator Studio. In this video, I'm gonna show you the features of the Instagram Creator Studio, how to see the insights, and share with you some differences with the Instagram mobile app. And I'll also show you how to schedule an Instagram post, so just keep watching. Hi everyone, I'm Gadis of Made by Mutiara and welcome back to my channel. So for me myself, I'm a creative calligrapher on Instagram where I do all sorts of art or lettering with many different mediums, and I do try to make an effort to post at least once a day. When it comes to scheduling posts, I know there are many different third-party websites or apps that allow you to do it through them, but there is always a limit to how many posts you can schedule under the free plan. So what I do instead as a free alternative option is to use the Instagram Creator Studio. However, there are some key differences with the Instagram Insights on your mobile versus the desktop. So I'm gonna show you what they are and see which one I prefer. But just keep in mind, if you wanna see the Instagram Insights, you must make sure that your account is set to a professional account, which is either the business or creator account. So if you're ready, let's just get right into it. So now I'm going to show you how to access the Instagram Creator Studio. And unfortunately, even if you use the Instagram website on desktop, there's no buttons anywhere that can bring you straight to the Instagram Creator Studio. So what you have to do instead is to search Instagram Creator Studio. And because Facebook and Instagram are under the same umbrella, it'll come out as Facebook Creator Studio. So even if you don't have a Facebook page, that's fine. Once you come in, they'll probably give you some prompts of how to sign up here and there. It's relatively easy. What could make it easier is to sign in Instagram inside your desktop already. So here I am. I don't know why it brings me to the Brand Collapse Manager. I'll go to that later. But I want to show you what the content library looks like first. You can see all of your posts, and at the same time, they can categorize your content with the posts that are just videos, posts that are just a single photo, carousel, this is what I use more often, and next, stories only if you want to show Insta stories, as well as IGTV. So let's look at this post over here. On the right, you can see they'll give you the breakdown of your Instagram insights. So I'll probably put up a screenshot here. On your mobile, they will show how many people reshare that post. So that's the difference with seeing each of the post insights from your mobile versus the desktop. One thing you can do is to actually download the video that you have uploaded into Instagram. So if you ever want to maybe upload it into YouTube or upload it into your blog, or you know, maybe you just want to keep the video for your own purposes inside your desktop itself. So that's something that you can do as well. One thing you cannot do, I thought it could do it, but it couldn't. I thought you could arrange the post by the number of likes and the number of comments, but apparently you cannot. So that's one disadvantage of the desktop app. On the Instagram Insights, if you access it on your mobile, you can arrange all of your posts according to the number of likes, number of saves, number of interactions, but that feature is not available over here. But what you can do is to actually view posts over a specific period of time. If I want to see all the posts that I posted since January 1st, for example, then I can arrange or adjust the range accordingly. So let me go to January and then until now, which is October, and I'll update. And then it will show me all the posts. If there's a need for you to use this custom range, then I guess the desktop version will come in handy. Insights. How does the insights differ with the mobile Instagram insight versus the desktop Instagram insights? So if you take a look here, it does show you the interactions as a graph. It shows you the breakdown of website visits, profile visits, so on and so forth. It tells you the account's reach over the last 7 days, and it tells you the impressions over the last 7 days as well, but there's no graph over there. So the only disadvantage of this desktop app, and I think just the disadvantage of Instagram in general when it comes to insights, is that it only gives you the info of the last 7 days. There's no way that you can adjust the time range to tell you like, okay, but how did I do this month? They don't have that feature available. Whereas if you were to use other websites or tools like Later or Planoly, all of these different sites, you may have to pay for them though. They do give you access to your insights for a longer period of time as compared to Instagram, which is just 7 days here. If you want to see me go through the Instagram insights, you can definitely check out my past video over here where I explain how I use Instagram insights to select the best time of the day to post, as well as what type of post works the best for me. While we are on the topic of insights, there's another tab here that says audience, so I'm going to tap on it and see what it tells me. It gives me a very nice colored graph of my breakdown of my followers, which is 19.9% women. It tells me when my followers are on Instagram, so this is in the day. This is not very helpful. So over here you have something called like a heat map, and it tells you the times of which my followers are on Instagram. This is one of the main features that I like about the Instagram Creator Studio, which the mobile Instagram Insights does not have. It tells me very nicely with a very visually appealing color. The darker it is, it means that the more people are on the website at that time. Whereas on the mobile app, what you have to do is to swipe through each day, and then you can see like the bar graph in general. Of course, that is still helpful, but I really like how this heat map gives me like a snapshot immediately. I can see 3 p.m. in general is the best time for me. Ideally, you want to post either slightly before or on the time that people are on Instagram, so you can engage with them while they're on the platform. Next thing you can see are the countries and top cities. You can also hover your mouse over to see the percentage of followers from those places. And that's it. That's all you can view on the Instagram Insights. What is the monetization tab? I'm also going to click on it because I'm not sure. I think this is a new feature by Instagram. If you ever work for brands, I suppose this is something that is relevant to you, where if you ever add in a tag or like paid partnership, it means that that brand is able to view the insights and the analytics for that post itself. And I cannot unlock portfolio, project briefs, settings, apply. And this is because even though you see here 10,000 or more followers, yes, even though I am 10,000 or more followers, the number of followers they are referring here is to Facebook followers, and unfortunately this is only for US users on Instagram. So for me, this is not my priority right now, but if I ever become interested in the future, then I'll just take note of these eligibility requirements. I'm gonna walk through how to upload a post and then talk through some of the features of what you can or cannot do. So I'm gonna create a post here, and then you can see that I have a selection of whether I want to upload Instagram feed or IGTV. So I'll just demo Instagram feed. So all you have to do is to just add content from file upload, or you can upload from Facebook page. And what you can do is tag people. So you can see if I want to tag someone, I can just click, and then if you type in, it will automatically suggest users for you. So because these are Windsor and Newton Inks, I can tap them. You can only tag up to 10 people that you don't follow, and you can have up to 20 tags for this image. Interesting. I did not know that you can only tag up to 10 people that you don't follow. And then you can save. Let's say I want to crop, so you can also crop in this image. So if you ever want to maximize the size of the image inside Instagram, the suggested one would be the square or vertical dimensions. So the only thing that you cannot do inside here is to edit your photos, where you want to adjust brightness, lightness, contrast, highlights, etc. If you do your editing separately on maybe Lightroom or Adobe Photoshop, then it's no problem. Another thing you can do is to rearrange the photo. So the only way you can do this is to type the number. So maybe I want this picture to be the first one over here, this number 3. So all you have to do is replace the number and tell it, okay, this is the first post, and enter, and it will automatically just jump and rearrange. So for the video, you can choose the thumbnail of the video, and the way you do it is that they will auto-generate some photos, and in this case here is 15 photos. So you can choose from this selection, or you can choose a frame. So this is the same way you would do it inside the Instagram app itself. If you upload a video, then you can just select a frame from the video itself. Or something that you can do that the Instagram app does not allow you to do is to add the image. So on Instagram, if you upload a video post, you can only choose the thumbnail from the video frame itself. Next thing, something that you can do on the Instagram Creator Studio that you cannot do on the Instagram mobile app is check how many mentions and hashtags you use. So you can see here, they have a counter telling you, okay, you have 2,200 characters left, 30 mentions and 30 hashtags. Okay, I'm gonna pick some old caption that I have here. Copy, paste. The hashtags are all highlighted for your reference. It tells me that I have one hashtag left. And the same way, if you were to start typing in your hashtag on your Instagram caption in your phone, you can also see that it will auto-complete or auto-suggest the hashtags to use inside the desktop app itself. So once you're happy, let's say I want to post, or I can save as draft, that's a good thing. I want to schedule it to post, when was the good time? 3 p.m? There you go. And now my post is being scheduled. So to find your posts that are being scheduled, just go to post status and then select schedule. I'm saying it weird, I'm so sorry. And there you have it. This is your post that you can schedule and you'll upload at the time that you give it. And that's the Instagram Creator Studio. I'll leave the link down in the description below so you can directly access the Instagram Creator Studio if you are on desktop and have fun exploring and seeing what you can do over there. And just to reiterate, there are many other different third-party websites that can do many of the features that the Instagram Creator Studio can do, and plus even more. But if you're looking for an option that say safer, that doesn't require any more signing up or any sort of payment, then this is something that you can consider as well. But let me know down in the comments below, are there any sort of social media apps or websites for Instagram that you'd like me to try, and I don't mind exploring it and showing you what I think. Although keep in mind, well, I don't really use scheduling or I don't really care so much about making my feed cohesive, I am very interested to see what the analytics tell me about my own Instagram account. So yeah, if you know of any websites that can give very interesting data, I'm very curious to know. Just let me know down in the comments below. And today's special goes to Marcella! Yay! So thank you so much for leaving a comment in my last video as well as sharing your excitement with me on your Instagram stories. If you want a shout out in my next video, be sure to leave a comment down below, or you can also share that you're watching this video in your Insta stories, and also remember to tag me on Instagram at madebymutiara. So thank you so much. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please give this a thumbs up if you do, and of course if you haven't, subscribed to this channel and click the bell if you want to be notified for my next video. Thank you again for all of your support, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.